I'm thankful and honored for being invited to this event. I am representing my university and my country, Peru. Today, I will present the winner project for the 2019 Artificial Intelligence Contest. This was organized by the e-government network for Latin America and the Caribbean region. It was sponsored by the Inter-American Development Bank and the Organization for American States. These contents, the goal was to generate and come up with solutions, artificial intelligence solutions, for improving the quality of life of the citizens in the region, in Latin America, in areas like security, transportation, health, for instance. So my team thought an artificial intelligence solution would be very valuable and also have a very high impact in the public health sector. I already heard it, but in Peru it's also the same problem. We have physicians to inhabitants ratio lower than recommended by OECD. Even worse outside the capital city, which is Lima, and in some regions like the Amazon, some cities you can only get by boat, by the river, or by plane. So doctors, physicians, they don't want to work or live there because it's those are isolated cities. So that's a problem. Access to specialists, access to health. The consequence, already mentioned here by other speakers, long waiting times in public hospitals, long queues, not enough specialists. So that's a big problem. And for those reasons, I can say that public hospitals don't have enough capacity to provide a high quality and timely service to the population. If you want an appointment with a specialist, you have to book that 1 month in advance, maybe, if you are lucky. It's not an exaggeration, but you could get worse, your condition could get worse, or you could die waiting for an appointment with a specialist. So, for this contest, my team thought about proposing an artificial intelligence solution for health, and we came up with this. We proposed a software application for cardiopulmonary diseases diagnosis. It uses an artificial intelligence deep learning model to diagnose up to 14 diseases. For example, pneumonia, infiltration, consolidation, cardiomegaly, etc. Some of these are common in Peru. Pneumonia, for example, they have a high death rate. Here you can see some images of X-ray, chest X-ray, from a data set that I will talk now. So we used the chest X-ray 14 dataset. Some speakers already mentioned that. We are aware that there are some limitations with the dataset, but the model was trained on this dataset. It has more than 100,000 images, chest X-ray images. It was collected by Professor Wang and his team at Stanford University. There's a research paper about this dataset. But at this point, I want to emphasize the following. It is very important to have a high quality, reliable, and big enough dataset for training and building artificial intelligence models. Thus, it's required to have to set public policies, standards, frameworks and protocols to collect, transport, secure, share, and use this data because it's it's very important, very valuable, and also you have to, it has ethical considerations and privacy considerations. As you know, big, huge amounts of data is required for, usually for artificial intelligence, machine learning, and in this case, deep learning. So it also depends on the nature of the problem and the prevalence of the disease you want to predict or classify, for example. And it's also harder to build a data set for medical images, for medical diseases. It takes more time and it's more expensive than in other domains. If you want to apply deep learning, machine learning to recognize the license number of a car, that's easier, but if you want to apply this to health, it's harder and it's more expensive and time consuming to build a data set for health. Well, on the technical part, on the technical side, we use a deep learning model based on the DenseNet 121 architecture, using convolutional neural networks. This type of neural networks is specialized in image analysis and pattern recognition. So that's why we use this. And how our project works. It's very simple. You upload a chest X-ray image to the application. The model, the artificial intelligence models, processes that image and gives you the probability of those 14 diseases. Like in this example, infiltration is the one that has the highest probability for this patient, for this X-ray image. Also, this can be a mobile application, it can be on the cloud also. But the takeaway, the conclusion is the following. We can build artificial intelligence solutions for health. There is huge potential, but we need to be aware of the challenges and set policies to guide implementation of these solutions with one goal in mind. Improve the quality of life of our citizens using this kind of technology. Well, this is my team, the X-ray team. We participated last year in Buenos Aires, Argentina, in this event. They are Henry Medina, Dennis Malky, Josimar Chiri, and Miguel Cotrina. Thank you very much.